guys, it's Jessie from the House of Healthy, and I'm here today for week 2 of the Spring Detox Program. So this is our spring cleaning program, the time to renew, refresh, and get energized. So in today's healthy living tip, we're going to talk about one of the best ways to energize. Now when you hear this, I don't want you to think like, oh gosh, this is what we're talking about today, this again, or how is that going to get me energized? So today we're going to talk about meditation. Now I know what you're thinking, sitting still doesn't sound very energizing. It sounds like it would kind of drain your energy, kind of spiral you into this like slump of sitting on the couch, turning on your DVR, turning on your Hulu, and watching hours and hours of TV or playing on the computer. But when you sit with purpose and you sit to meditate, it can clear a lot of things that you waste your energy on. So a lot of frustrations, a lot of mental chatter, kind of these things that you have going on in your mind all day, a lot of tension that builds up that if you don't address, it really sucks the energy out of you and creates more stress. Now when we're stressed, we of course have less energy, and when we're stressed, we kind of feel like poo. So we basically don't feel great, we don't feel like we're thriving, and it is kind of the opposite of detoxing. When we're detoxing, we want to do all these things that make us feel great and make us feel alive and energized. Feeling stressed, anxious, worried, just like you have so much to do, or maybe that your body is just really tired and needs time to sit, that will make you feel less energized. So to detox, to re-energize, sometimes you just need to take a seat. And when you sit with purpose, it helps you to re-energize, helps you to de-stress, rather than to just kind of shut the mind off for a little bit and ignore what's going on. So there's a few things we're gonna do with this. You can sit on a cushion or a chair or kind of a spot that feels like a nice place that you could kind of focus and decompress. So it might be, you know, right in the middle of your living room, it might be a nice corner somewhere in your house or a room that you can close the door, find quiet. It could be outside somewhere in the sunshine, anywhere that feels right to you. And then you're just gonna take a seat. So you wanna sit with a tall spine. If you feel that really bothers your back to sit that tall, go ahead and sit in a chair so you have some support behind you. Otherwise, you can sit onto a cushion that might be a little bit more comfortable and a little bit lower to the ground. And what I want you to do for this meditation is to find a quote or some kind of mantra or saying that motivates you. So it doesn't have to be some big Sanskrit mantra, although it can be, and that's wonderful. But it can also just be maybe your favorite quote from a book or a movie or a writer or a poet, or maybe something that you've seen on Facebook that someone posted and you thought like, oh man, I love that, and you shared it with your friends. So find something that sits with you. My quote is something that comes from a movie. So it's not some grand movie, I mean, I think it's grand, but it's not some, you know, huge yogic movie or anything, or even anything about meditation. Mine is from the movie Castaway. So there's a part where he, spoiler alert, where he gets saved, and he's on the airplane afterwards, and they ask him, you know, what are you going to do? And he says, well, you just have to keep breathing, because tomorrow the sun will rise, and who knows what the tides might bring. So as soon as I saw that, I thought, wow, that's so true. No matter what, as long as you keep breathing, tomorrow the sun will rise. Who knows what could happen tomorrow? The possibilities are endless. So when you're stuck in a moment, and feel free to use that quote if you'd like, when you're stuck in some kind of moment and you're feeling this, just know that tomorrow could be completely different for you. So find a mantra, find some sort of a quote like that that works for you, and it could be as simple as, I've got this. And that could be your mantra. If that's what motivates you, that is awesome. And then take a comfortable seat, nice tall spine, and I want you to sit for about 5 minutes. Maybe more if you have time or if you feel able to, if your body doesn't feel kind of tight from sitting that long. And I just want you to think about this quote and just slowly let it kind of roll through your mind until it almost starts to fade away. And as it does this, you might notice that a few things pop up or you might have some thoughts kind of interject, and that's okay. These are great learning experiences. You can kind of see like how your mind reacts to wanting to stay slow, and you can maybe see if there's one thing that really keeps popping up, that might be that major stressor that you want to address in your life. And while you're breathing, or while you're thinking of this quote, I want you to focus on your breath. So I want you to breathe deeply, nice big inhales. And I want you to think of filling up really slow, like the breath is just slowly dripping in and slowly dripping out. So you get this nice, slow, filling inhale through your nose, slow and steady release of the exhale through your nose. And again, you'll sit there for about 5 minutes, and you might find that just sitting there and only having that one thing to focus on, that one thing that means so much to you, and that allows you to breathe, completely changes the way you feel, leaves you energized, and leaves you detoxified. Now, if you want to take this one step further, actually two steps further, there's two other things that you can do. So if you did have this one thing that kept popping up, this maybe one stressor, or you had a lot of things coming in your mind and it was hard to focus, after you sit down, grab a piece of paper and I want you to write for 5 minutes. So don't stop writing the entire time. Even if you think you have nothing to write, just say like, I have nothing to write right now, I can't think of anything, but hopefully something will come, and just keep moving. And you might be surprised at how much you can release onto that paper. And it's not something that anyone else has to read. It's just something that you can even ball up and throw away afterwards just to get it all out and to clear some space in the mind and in the body. Now, another thing that you can do, that's great if you really have a lot of stress built up and you really have just so many thoughts going on and you want to get them all down and out to clear space. Now, if you're feeling pretty good in that meditation, or you've done this and you want to see what happens with that space and what happens with that kind of sense of calm and peace, I want you to take that into your daily tasks, and you can bring your meditation into something so you can stay with that kind of detoxifying calm state throughout your day. Now, a lot of people sit on the mat and then that's it, and you might find that there are times where like you are, you know, something goes wrong and you're cooking and you burn the food and you get really frustrated. Well, that's a great time to bring this in. Come back to your quote, you've got this, it's all right, tomorrow's a new day, just breathe. Or bring it into maybe a task that you could focus all of your attention on that usually you multitask with. So I like to do this when I do the dishes. Rather than trying to toast bread, watch a program, do the dishes, add some laundry in, I just simply focus on doing the dishes. And I stay there in that moment. Maybe I have like a cup of tea brewing or something on the background, but I take that moment that I have to just simply sit and do the dishes. And you'll find that that even brings you that meditative quality. So that's something that you can always add in as well. And you'll slowly find that the stress peels away a bit, that you breathe deeper and you feel a little more breath in your life, which leaves you energized and leaves you detoxified. So that is one quick thing that you can do. Take 5 minutes, maybe every day, maybe once a week, whenever you can, to just sit. Find stillness, find that quote that resonates with you, and go for it. Now, in the next few videos, we'll be talking about a few other things that you can do to detoxify. So some things that I'll be showing you how to make a few things, and some wonderful things that you could do to help really bring clarity throughout the body, mind, and spirit. And of course, look for the Detox Yoga series, which will come out tomorrow. And this will be the continuation of last week's Sun Salutations, where we'll work towards that full-length detoxifying yoga practice. So stay tuned for that. And I want to ask you one more thing. So for a challenge today, I want you to leave a comment below, either in YouTube or on Facebook or on the blog, and let me know what the one thing that you really wish you could detoxify out of your life is. Now, it can be some sort of a food habit, exercise habit, or your major stressor, and tell me what the one step that you are gonna take to help detoxify that. So if it's going to be a clean eating habit, if you're going to try some detox yoga, or maybe you're going to address that one major thing that is stressing you out with meditation and mindful sitting, I want to know. So let's leave it below in the comments, and we'll figure out together how we can work through this and how we can really bring energy, clarity, and detoxify your life. For more information, stop by thehouseofhealthy.com, like on Facebook, follow on Pinterest and Twitter, and of course subscribe here at the YouTube channel. Thank you so much for stopping by. Have a happy and healthy day.